We are discussing dialogue between Rama and our Vashistha, the great master, and we are discussing on the answer to Rama and the question. Today he is going to put another question. जो वस्तु प्रमाणों द्वारा जैसे जानी जाती है उसकी वैसे ही सत्ता होती है, अन्य रूप से नहीं। ब्रह्म तो प्रमाणों द्वारा जाना नहीं जाता, अतः वह सद्रूप है। यह निश्चय कैसे किया जा सकता है? और जगत प्रमाणों द्वारा सत्रूप प्रतीत होता है, वह असत है। यह निश्चय कैसे किया जा सकता है? इस प्रकार श्री रामचंद्र जी का शंका करते हैं। भगवान परमात्मा सत है, यह कैसे प्रतीत हो? और इतना विशाल तथा विविध प्राणी प्रमाणों द्वारा सिद्ध इस जगत नामक हृदय से वी हैव so many proofs on the world. World is visible and it is true. We have so many proofs, and you say there is no world. There is no world, and we have no proof. In common life, we don't see any proof because we don't see the truth, absolute truth, which we call God. So, how can we have some proofs for God, for absolute truth? Please explain me. Vashistha ji is answering, Brahma pramanon dwara nahi gyant hota hai, is kathan ki siddhi nahi hoti, kyunki jadi pratibandhak na ho, to mahavakyon dwara uska gyan hota hai. Brahma pramanon dwara nahi gyant hota hai, is kathan ki siddhi nahi hoti. क्योंकि यदि प्रतिबंधक न हो तो महावाक्यों द्वारा उसका ज्ञान होता है, और प्रमाणों द्वारा ज्ञान नहीं होता है, ऐसा नहीं कर सकता है। प्रमाण है। He says we have proofs for the truth and it can be proved and it can be experienced if the highest words of the Vedas are understood and practiced and realized, then the Brahman, the absolute truth, can be realized, it can be experienced. So we cannot say there is no proof. There is proof. Pratibandhak ka nas to Brahma mein adhyast dvet ke mithyatva jnan se hi hota hai, kyunki jahan par rajju mein sarp ka bhram hota hai, wahin par jab tak sarp ka nished na ho तब तक रज्जु का ज्ञान नहीं हो सकता है। इस आशय से श्री वशिष्ठ जी कहते हैं, श्री वशिष्ठ जी टोल्ड, सी बाय एराडिकेटिंग द ऑब्स्टेकल्स, बाय पुटिंग आउट द ऑब्स्टेकल्स, वी कैन हैव द नॉलेज ऑफ द रियल ऑब्जेक्ट। फॉर एग्जांपल, इफ यू superimpose the snake on the rope till you have not driven out the idea of snake from this rope, you cannot see the rope and you cannot understand what is rope. So you have, if the obstacles are taken out, the truth reveals itself. What are the obstacles? Some hiding factors, some enveloping, some covering factors are there due to which you are unable to see the truth. So here some ideas of snake due to darkness or due to some other reasons, you have the idea, so that idea comes first, which hides the truth, that is rope. So if you can remove these ideas of snake, then the reality will be revealed. So that is the way the truth can be realized, and when it is realized, the proof is direct. There is no need of any indirect or imaginary proofs needed.
तो उसने कभी देखा ही होगा ना?
वो हमारे उसमें ये तो साधारण हम दे देते हैं उदाहरण और लोग साधारण मान लेते हैं, हाँ भाई ठीक है, लेकिन इसके लिए फिर तर्क भी तर्क आर्गुमेंट गोज ऑन एंडलेसली दे गो ऑन आर्गुइंग लॉजिक and logic of course leads nowhere, but it helps to achieve the goal. It cannot make you understand the reality, but it can help to some extent. So they say, of course you must have seen snake somewhere, so snake is there. You cannot say snake is not there. Where from you got the idea? So they explain in a way, in many ways, by logic. Yes, of course, snake is seen somewhere, but not here. Somehow you have brought the idea here and you see the snake. So unless you confirm it, it is, you cannot say, you cannot prove that it is snake, unless you have confirmation of it. Of course, you might have seen snake somewhere. And the other logic says, if you have seen snake somewhere, that is also not snake. Whatever you see by your eyes, and your perceptive eyes are defective. So, even if you have seen snake somewhere else, that is also not snake, that is something else. How our instruments are defective? They say, by which means you perceive the objects? By mind only. And mind is so flittering. It is always changing so rapidly. It never stops on one object for fraction of second. It goes on changing. So how can you understand what it is? This is one logic. Say you are running fast in the road, and can you know what is written in the milestones? Because of your speed, you cannot understand what is written there on the side signboard or milestones. If you stand there steadily for some time, then only you can understand what is written there. So steadiness is a must, but mind cannot be steadied. So you don't know what you are seeing. So your defective instrument, which is nothing other than the mind, is wrong. Whatever it perceives, it is wrong. Okay, now if you have seen the snake somewhere, you have not seen the snake. How can you prove? If your instrument is proved to be faulty, how can you prove what is seen by the instrument? They give so many examples. If you have jaundice, Dr. Sahib, jaundice. So what do you see outside? Everything is yellow. But is it true? With a perfect eye, see, a person sees everything with different colors. And you see, because of your defective eyes, everything is only yellow. So how can you prove?
You cannot superimpose snake and a rope unless there is darkness. Daytime, suppose I see a snake and a rope, I cannot superimpose. Superimpossible because of darkness. Same darkness.
That is also
but
there.
Same darkness.
There are
the idea of snake and rope mixed up because of darkness. Same darkness.
There are so many logics. From
Agyanta.
Ignorance is darkness. Darkness is nothing but ignorance, your inability to see the real fact. That is called ignorance. So here from it comes, what is the way to eradicate it? Only way, when you get somehow or other the real knowledge of the hidden truth, then it vanishes by itself. There is no need of doing any effort to drive it away. Because ignorance is the absence of knowledge. It is not something which should be or could be removed. For our example, I always say, you see, late last night, the ghost came to our gate side and it was standing there. And we are arguing on how many horns it had. So, go on arguing till the eternity. No conclusion will be achieved. But the moment you know there was no ghost, all the problems are over. Now, when daytime comes, when there is light, you see no ghost. It was an idea only. So now, what have you done to drive out the ghost from the gate side? Have you done any effort? Only light. That means the knowledge. When the knowledge dawns, then there is no need of driving out the ignorance. It automatically vanishes. Why? Because there is no presence of absence. There is no presence of absence. Absence is ignorance. Means absence of knowledge is called ignorance. So, can there be any presence of absence? do you catch the point, logic? Nasato vidyate bhavah, na bhavo vidyate satah. The presence cannot be absence. And absence cannot be presence. So, absence cannot be proved. And you have the logic, you say, we have so many proofs for the world which is absent. why do you see all this visible world and how many proofs you have? Some subtle logic is there. Of course, your logic, your proofs are true. But how long, where from all these proofs have come? These proofs are made by the ignorance itself. These proofs are taken out of the world only, from ignorance only, and you claim we have the proofs. So how can you prove? For example, our ghost, we can have so many proofs. It had three horns instead of two. We can prove it. How do you prove? Are my grandma said, it had two horns in the front and one behind. So three horns. So all these proofs are based upon only ideas and wrong ideas. So we cannot rely upon it. Whatever proofs you take to prove the existence of the world, all these proofs are taken from the world itself. World means your mind, ever-changing mind. How can you say our proofs are correct? How can you say? Ever-changing mind gives the proof, or intellect, same thing. So you cannot prove the absence to be present. And how can you give the proof of the truth? Because we have so many logics which prove the truth exists. So many proofs. You see, somebody said there is no, I have not seen the truth, I have not seen God, I don't believe God. Okay, you don't believe God, we accept it. But do you believe yourself? You have to say yes. There is no excuse. You have to agree, or you have to accept your presence. You are there, that's why you are telling God is not there. So your presence, we say, we say that your presence is God. And what else? You know you exist, you are present. So your knowledge of your existence also is God. And you are pleased or satisfied, or you are happy with your existence. That we call it bliss. That is God. Existence absolute, and knowledge absolute, and bliss absolute are told as God or Supreme Truth. Of course, you can say, I exist, but what proof that you exist? So there also we can have the logic. Everybody, all the objects of this world, visible world, they have the existence, or else you cannot say it exists. There is some object which has got no existence, can you say so? There is some object which has got no existence, can you say so? Can you accept this logic? So whatever exists that can be said to be some object or something. The existence cannot be denied in any case, anywhere, by any means. So existence is all-pervading and it is one and it is the basic principle which is realized by every object, every being. This cannot be denied. This way we have got so many proofs for God. Aptavakya, the words of the realized souls who have experienced the truth, who have experienced the bliss and knowledge, they express, yes, the truth is. So if you have not seen some object and somebody says, I have seen, you have to accept it because you have not seen it. Because you are ignorant, you have to rely upon the words of the wise. You are bound to. And if you can claim that I have seen the object which was not there, that also is baseless. You cannot say so. You cannot argue, I have seen the object which was not there. Can you say so? So by no means you can prove the absence and you can prove the presence. And who have experienced this, whatever they say, you are bound to accept it. Because you have not seen, so we cannot rely upon your logic. Witness, how the judges take the witness. One who has seen it, he can be the witness only. Seeing means by many means. There are six types of proofs and any proof will do, either direct or indirect or guess or by indirect method. Who has seen it, you can rely on it. So proofs are there. This is how Vashistha is bringing the logic to prove the truth. Vashistha ji ne kaha hai Sri Ramchandra ji, jaise roopihin akash mein neel peet adi roop dekhe jate hain, vaise hi chinmay brahm mein yah jagat brahm utpanna hua hai. He gives the example also. You see, what is the color of the sky? Sometimes generally it looks like blue. If you analyze or if you investigate, do you see any blueness anywhere in the sky? There is no blueness. It is just an idea. It is not the truth. So yet it appears to be, and sometimes it appears to be red or yellow or colorful in the evening sky. Before sunrise, it looks reddish. Is the sky red? Where from you got this red color? It is just idea, it is not the truth. But the sky is there, you cannot say there is no sky. If there is no sky, how can you say the sky is red? But the reddish color is not there. Why is not there? Because it never remains red continuously. So we cannot say it is red. Now, just as the sky is seen in different colors and say rainbow, Where from you get all those seven colors in the rainbow? Are there any colors really? Somehow some color is seen, which is not there. This is how the truth, when not understood, appears as this world. The world is there, but in what form? That redness is there. We see it. The visibility is redness. But on what? It itself is not there, but it is based on the sky. So also, your visible world is not there, and behind it, the holder of it, the substratum of it, the screen behind the picture is true, that is truth. Ukta jagat bhram ke अत्यंताभाव के ज्ञान में यदि अत्यंत दृढ़ता हो तभी ब्रह्म का पूर्वोक्त रूप ज्ञान होता है, अन्य कर्म से नहीं. देर इज वन एंड वन अलोन पाथ, ओनली वन पाथ, ओनली वन पाथ टू रियलाइज द ट्रूथ. बट इट इज बाय नॉलेज ऑफ इट. Knowledge is the only source. For example, I always give you the example of the lion. Say, you are all alone traveling and you have missed the way at dark night. It was cloudy, pitch dark night. And you have lost the way, and you have entered into the forest, and you are just going here and there aimlessly, and all of a sudden you saw some lion is standing before you. What will happen? All alone, in pitch dark night, and in the dense forest, the lion is standing before you. How will you feel? all the troubles, all the fears. You may have a heart attack also. Yes. You are not afraid?
I will have heart attack.
Now I will make bypass surgery. Okay. See now, all of a sudden, there was lightning. Because it was cloudy night, that's why it was so pitch dark. And you saw, by the lightning, it was a stone lion. It was not real lion, it was a stone lion, some dilapidated, abandoned, some fort of some king in long past was there in the forest, and that lion was made by stone and it was lying somewhere near a gate. And now you are confirmed it is not the lion. Now again after lightning, what happens? Again same pitch dark night. Isn't it? Now will you believe the unreality of a real lion standing before you, even though darkness pervades everywhere? You are unable to see, and yet you can play with the lion. You can catch it, you can ride over it, and you can hide below the belly because it is night. So let me take shelter under it. Everything you can do. So this is called real knowledge, done of knowledge. This is the only way to get out, get rid of your fears and all the troubles. There is no other way. How not? Suppose somebody says, there is no lion, don't fear. It is only a stone lion. Of course, you may believe a little, but is it confirmed? You may hear from me or from many other teachers, there is no world. You may hear from the tape record. Continuously the tape record is telling, there is no world. Will you believe it? Unless and until you realize the truth behind this darkness of ignorance, you cannot be assured. So the knowledge, and that knowledge should be experiential knowledge, confirmed knowledge, established knowledge. You cannot get out of all these troubles which we have in this world. Can anybody say, I have no trouble in this world, visible world? Of course, some people say, no, I have never wept in my life. I have only laughed in my life. I have no troubles. I am quite well off. They say, but the moment his father will die, he will go, he will weep in a corner somewhere. Outside you will say, no. Everybody dies. I have no trouble. No problem. Everybody is having problems and miseries in this world. That's why Lord Krishna declares, Dukkhalayam Asaswatam. The signboard is written there, you see, on the arch, Sivananda Ashram. When you enter in, can you say Ramakrishna Mission inside? The signboard is there before you. It is Sivananda Ashram. When you enter, you will find people of Sivananda Ashram only. Similarly,